Rakesh. I head up the Ventures Division for Reckitt. For those of you who don't know Reckitt, as you got from the intro, it's the company that makes Dettol. It's the most relevant brand today. But the most exciting brand also, it also is the company that makes Durex. Probably the crowd goes up every time I say that. It's one of the top 10 FTSE companies in the UK right now. And we're very happy to be here and have a brief at MadFest. The brief that was given to the startups was essentially to break the chain of infection. Now that sounds like typical corporate words that can ever be written on a piece of paper. But what does it mean? It means, you know, if I'm holding this mic, if I've got COVID, I've been vaccinated, I don't have COVID. But if I do have COVID, I've spread the germs to the microphone, and the next person I pass it on to, it continues the chain of infection. So how can you use technology to break this chain of infection? So that was the brief we'd given the startups. I think there are six startups pitching, Jeremy?
Six startups.
Super cool. So, and we'll meet all of them. I welcome all of you to ask them questions. And I think my team are all here who will definitely ask them questions. So just put your hand up and ask questions. It breaks Jeremy's process, but that's okay.
Love that. And Rakesh, what are you looking for in today's startups? Like what would be the winning company?
It's a good question. So what we're looking for is three things. Number one, a spectacular team. We've worked with about 100 startups now as a team, and we realized that the idea actually matters less than the team. The team actually sometimes is the only thing that matters. So that's the first thing we look for, a super passionate team who believe in purpose. Woo! So that's one of the teams, clearly. The second thing we're going to look for is how close they are to consumers and how much they care about consumer feedback, how they've changed their business as a reflection of that. So consumer intimacy is the second thing we're going to look for. And third is whether they're a truly purpose-led business. Now, as most companies these days are trying to become triple bottom line companies, we really care about companies that are trying to do that and how they want to evolve their path to becoming a triple bottom line company. So that's the third thing we're going to look for.
Okay, brilliant. Well, hello. Take a seat.
It's a bit weird. First pitch I've given in a while where you can actually see how tall I am. I'm Johnny. I'm the founder and CEO of SoPost, and we help our partners do one thing really, really, really well. That one thing is product sampling. Our business is built on the fundamental belief that if you can get the right product sample into the right person's hands, it converts. But I'm not here to talk about myself today. I'm here to talk about Reckitt and the brief that you gave us around how we can help educate consumers. We spend a lot of time looking at your online presence, with Dettol in particular, and we actually think you do a really good job of educating people already. Whether it's on brand.com or through social, there's content absolutely everywhere. And personally, I feel very engaged, and your stuff was very clear to me. However, we felt one thing was missing, because of course, through the pandemic, and I think it's a trend that's going to continue for a long time now, we're spending way more time online on our devices. And the one thing that you're not offering consumers at the moment is this opportunity for trial. I've seen this in every single tube station I've walked through. I've seen them dotted around today. And this is amazing because I can actually try Dettol and I can experience the benefits for myself. No longer am I just reading about how good the product is, but I can actually experience it and take an action afterwards. And that is where SoPost comes in. We launched in 2012, and today we partner with hundreds of brands to help them run physical product sampling activities online through almost any channel. For us, we really act as the infrastructure for online sampling, and we allow our partners to plug sampling into media buys, into content, their partnerships with influencers. So you can no longer just tell people about the product and explain the benefits to them, but you can actually get a physical trial product into their hands without them ever leaving that environment. For us, it's all about getting these samples to people in a way that is very much focused on relevance, so you're not wasting samples on the wrong people. It's about data, helping you capture high quality, opted-in, zero-party data from the right individuals. And it's all about the insights and analytics that happen afterwards. This is a slightly simplified view of what the sampling experience looks like. It starts with an activation, so that could be through your media buy, it could be through a channel of our own, through our publisher partnerships. There's that initial engagement, and then from there, there's really five further steps where we capture some data, which I'll come on to in a second. We do a lot of intelligent filtering of orders. One of the big challenges that brands have found when they try to sample online themselves is that it's very easy to give away a lot of product. It's a lot harder to ensure those samples are going to the right people, not just people who are looking for free stuff. So we've got some really cool technology that can actually analyze and personalize the experience that the consumer has. We take care of the distribution of samples for you as well. We have distribution hubs all over the world. We've also worked very hard to ensure that we're doing this stuff in a very environmentally friendly way. And then following that trial experience, there's a lot of work that we do to help you capture feedback. That can be through surveys. We can also capture and syndicate ratings and reviews to brand.com and the retailers that you're working with. I seem to have mucked up the order of my slides slightly, so we're going to jump around a little bit. But the big reason why our partners work with SoPost, as opposed to trying to do this themselves or working with other sampling vendors, is really based on three things. The first is that bit around relevance. We're the only sampling company out there that can actually ensure samples are going to those right individuals rather than people who are looking for free stuff. Secondly, the experience is paramount to us. We're a team of 60 people globally today. We've got a very strong engineering arm with some amazing product and UX people within that. And we ensure that every experience is brand first. SoPost very much lives in the background. And then the third thing is on the data side. Not just the names and email addresses that we capture for you. By the way, we tend to see about half of individuals do opt in. But we can help you enhance your CRM databases, and we can help you capture a ton of relevant insights through those surveys and through the reviews that come through as well. It's probably worth mentioning that in addition to the real benefits that our platform gives you, everything we do for our enterprise customers is on an account managed basis. So not only do you have the power of the platform, but you have a very passionate, very engaged team who can help you optimize and build out these experiences as well. Whilst everything is account managed, we have a full reporting interface. So if at any time you wanted to jump in and look at those insights, access is available and you can drill into pretty much whatever you want. So just in summary, I'm Johnny. I'm from SoPost. And we help our partners run We help our partners run really powerful product sampling experiences online with a key focus on relevance, data, and analytics. Thank you.
Okay. Well done, Johnny. All right. Question from Reckitt.
Hi there. Two questions. Do you help companies actually take the product and create it into samples as well? So if we were to give you a full-size product, could you do that execution? And then the second part is, does the samples need to be worth a certain value or a certain size to actually get the right engaged consumers to request them?
Good questions, thank you. So on that first point, that's not something that we do ourselves. However, we do partner with a number of companies that can support with that. And we've actually worked really hard to integrate what they do and what we do to create a lot of efficiencies in that process. On that second question, it does matter and it doesn't matter. It really depends on what the objectives are. One of the benefits that we have is because we're sort of processing millions of orders every month now, and we have a lot of data that compares the impact of a low-value sample versus a high-value sample. So depending on what your objectives for the campaign are, we can recommend what format is best for that.
Okay. Very cool.
And the winner is SoPost.
SoPost, there we go. Congratulations.
Congratulations.